Three updates coming up on Pinax TV. A Ghanaian businessman has sued ex-president John Dramani Mahama. He has taken him to court. He is saying that he wants ex-president John Dramani Mahama to drop out of the upcoming NDC general elections. We'll give you more updates on that one. And also, that same Mahama is in the news after he showed some gory and bad images. What happened at Ayawaso Westwagon? He showed it to some foreign diplomat, painting the whole of Ghana black. And what's more, he even said that the president, that's Nana Addo Dankwa Akufo-Addo, can't even take care of we Ghanaians. A very sad one. Also in the news, Kwesi Otheng, who's a gospel musician, has met with the president of the Republic of Ghana, and he has presented something to him. We'll give you more updates on all of this issue. Let's start off with the issue of the moment. We all know that in no time we'll be having the NDC presidential election here in Ghana, and as noted, the person who has been tipped to win this particular presidential race is none other than our own ex-president John Dramani Mahama. But then there could be a twist of things or change of events, because a Ghanaian businessman all of a sudden has emerged, and he has taken the former president of the Republic of Ghana, John Mahama, to court in his bid, challenging his bid for him to contest in the upcoming presidential election, particularly for the NDC. According to this particular businessman, whose name is Stephen Ajiman, there's a particular article in our 1992 constitution which prohibits people or persons who have been president before in Ghana from further contesting to become president again. This is what this particular businessman is saying, whose name is Stephen Ajiman. Let's read this and explain further what this particular man is saying. Stephen Ajiman is praying the High Court to declare that Mr. Mahama, in raising funds to support his bid to be elected as a flag bearer or presidential candidate of the National Democratic Congress, that's the NDC, in his capacity as a former president of the Republic of Ghana, violates Article 68, Clause 2 of the 1992 Constitution. He is further praying the court to hold that former President John Mahama's establishment of a campaign office for the purpose of seeking to coordinate his activities in his quest to become flag bearer or presidential candidate of the NDC constitutes an office of emolument and also profits within the context of Article 68(2) of the 1992 Constitution, and same having been established without parliamentary permission was in contravention of Article 68, Clause 2 of the 1992 Constitution. Let's break this down for our lovely subscribers right here on this particular channel. What this man by the name Stephen Ajiman, who is a businessman, as we said earlier, is saying is that there's a particular article in our 1992 Constitution which prohibits people or persons who have been president before of the Republic of Ghana to further contest in upcoming general elections or flag bearer elections so that they can become a president again of the Republic of Ghana. So for instance, we all know that J.A. Kufuor, that's John Ejekun Kufuor, is the ex-president of Ghana. He went for 2 terms and then he won. So if J.A. Kufuor is again contesting NDC MPP primaries, like he's contesting for MPP flag bearership positions, and he wins, it violates our constitution, because under the constitution you can't become a president and again go and contest in another presidential election or flag bearership election to become a president of the same country. This is what this man is saying. We have no idea, but then as he said, he's standing on Article 68, Clause 2 of the 1992 Constitution. So according to this man, whatever the president or the ex-president of the Republic of Ghana is doing, it violates our constitution, particularly Article 68, Clause 2 of the 1992 Constitution. He has taken Mahama to court, and this time around he has vowed that he will make sure that ex-president John Dramani Mahama will not even contest for him to even win in the first place. That's the upcoming NDC flag bearership position. We don't know how this will play out, but then we have the rate and can confirm that this particular issue which came from the businessman is really true and a legitimate one. What Mahama will do, we have no idea, but up to now, since the case has been sent to court, we can confirm that Mahama won't contest in the meantime in the upcoming NDC flag bearership position. So we don't know if they will have to pull the date forward or they will have to reschedule it again. Also, that same Mahama is in the news. You all saw what happened at Ayawaso Westwagon. Everybody condemned it. International communities, our president, everybody condemned it, where some people who dressed like police people were beating people up. At the end, about 80 people were shot and a lot of people were wounded. President Mahama also condemned it, but he has done the unthinkable, because he has invited foreign diplomats, particularly businessmen and politicians from outside the country, and he has gathered them in a room and showed them a video of what went on at Ayawasuwe Swagon, and even at the point in time telling the people that Ghana can't even handle our own affairs, our security system is weak, and what's more, the president of the Republic of Ghana can't do anything about this situation, talking about even protecting we the citizens and even stopping election violence. This was what the president of the Republic of Ghana said. This was what the ex-president of the Republic of Ghana said. That is ex-president John Dramani Mahama. Without much talk, let's play an audio of when he had this meeting with the foreign diplomats.
It is obvious that this was a partisan deployment, and we'll show you two more short videos, very short. The first one is this one. This is the funeral of the late MP, the MP who died. This is his funeral. These are those forces again at the funeral. So the MPP who died, the senior NPP officials were all there at his funeral, and these forces were at the funeral, dancing. These are not security personnel. I mean, Ghana Police Service and other security personnel do not wear earrings and things like that. I could see one of them had an earring in his ear. I mean, this is just a band of hoodlums put in uniforms and deployed for a purpose. And this happened before the election. And so it means that they had been camped already in preparation for the election. So this is the first video. I'll let you see another one. This one. These two vehicles, this black Land Cruiser and the one behind it, are the vehicles of the parliamentary candidate for Ayawaso West Wagon, the MPP candidate, Lydia, who is currently in parliament. Now watch behind the cars. You see a police vehicle. You see those guys again. They were escorting her from polling station to polling station. And so they were providing security to the parliamentary candidate of the NPP. This is the meteorological station, the headquarters of the meteorological agency. There's a polling station there. And so she was going on an inspection of the polling stations, and these guys who perpetrated the violence were escorting her from polling station to polling station. I mean, if they were neutral participants, what would they be doing escorting one parliamentary candidate and then attacking the house of another and discharging weapons and injuring people? And so it just shows absolute proof that this was a partisan deployment, and as they themselves said, a dress rehearsal for the year 2020.
So there you have it. This is what ex-president John Dramani Mahama said in the meeting, which has raised a lot of attention, and a lot of people are talking about it, because according to them, he has sold Ghana on a cheap platter, because everybody has a problem in his country. US currently is facing an emergency, a national emergency, but you don't really hear it here in Ghana. Nigeria also is having their own crisis in terms of election, but everybody tries as much as possible to solve the problem and perhaps know how to go around it. But then if you call foreign diplomats in the country, show them a video, paint our system, our security system and our election, everything bad, then I think it's really bad for the image of our beloved country, Ghana. This is just, I mean, opinion based, but then this was what the president or the ex-president of the Republic of Ghana, John Dramani Mahama, did, which a lot of people have condemned. Moving on to the next story, Kwesi Otheng, who is a gospel musician here in Ghana, we all know that he supported our president of the Republic of Ghana, talking about Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo, proud to the 2016 elections. He even endorsed him, and then thank God that he won to become the president of the Republic of Ghana. Even though things are not going on well here in Ghana, he's still the president and also the man of the moment. So finally, he said, Kwesi Otheng said that he's bringing up a new album, even though we've not heard his song in a while now. And the name of the title of that particular album is Anthem. He had the opportunity to meet with the president of the Republic of Ghana at the Flagstaff House, and he presented to him the first copy of his album. The title of the album, as you said earlier, on is Anthem, and the president of Ghana was so much happy, because Kwesi Otheng is a gospel musician, and he, being the first gentleman of the land, had the privilege to get the first copy of this particular album. So that's all for today. Let us know what you think in the comment section below. Also like and share this video to your various social media handles. Thank you very much for watching.